Hello, this is Hirodov YouTube channel. In this video I will review for you a special multimeter. Comes in this nice bag and it's model number HoldPeak HP-90EPD. Unfortunately it came with this display. It works perfectly, but there is something on the display. Here are instructions manual, intelligent digital multimeter, operator's manual. This one is much better than the other one which I already reviewed, and it's pretty popular on YouTube. This is much more expensive, much more modern, and it comes with more extensions. For other one I had to buy separately crocs, and I still can use these crocs. And here are the different meters. Now it's off. Here are hertz, temperature 26 degrees, battery meter, maybe ampere, and first one is volts, and this is resistance in ohms. Here I have also select, hold, range, and release. A lamp, hertz, and everything nice. Now let's insert the extensions, volt and hertz, meter, nice one with 9 volt battery as the other one. Holder here, and it's anti-shock. Cover, so it's ready for professional use. Multimeter, let's insert here for voltage, and the other one for voltage shall be here. Let's see if there is something on the instruction manual telling me where the voltage shall go, frequency, resistance, and so on. Max feed, T plus, T minus, volt and hertz. So let's try this one back, turn it on. Right now minus 2 plus 8 volts in normal usage. So here I have this energy shuko contacts. Right now, no, it's off, no voltage. Let's switch on and see what happens. Nothing happens, so maybe this is not the correct way. Let's see. And here is how to measure resistance in ohms. When the both ends are together, it shall be zero, which is correct, or around zero. And now when I touch with my body, this is the resistance of my body. in ohms. Let's show again. When both are touched, it's zero or very slight resistance for the extensions, and now with my finger, the resistance of my fingers. My body is still transferring some electricity flow, but with big resistance. And now, according to the instructions, measuring DC and AC voltage, connect the red one to the V connector and the black one to COM connector. Then select voltage, and now it's in DC mode, so for AC mode, select must be clicked, and now I can measure the electricity voltage. Here it is connected and currently showing 10 volts around. Now when I switch, it goes to 233 volts, 232, which is in the specification of 220 to 250 volts. Next measurement is for measuring frequency and duty cycle, COM jack and V hertz jack. So frequency in hertz, let's switch, almost 50 hertz, 49.97, which is in the specification close enough to 50 hertz. It works, nice device. Next measurement is temperature. Is this Fahrenheit? Hold, release. Okay, again. And now for amperage. Battery temperature, COM and T plus jack. So for measuring temperature, I have to switch here. Minus 20 degrees, it's correct, T plus and T minus. So instruction manual is of high importance. Now for measuring amperage, capacitance, resistance, voltage, current. Here is battery testing, black to COM, red to UA, ME A. Here is one battery, right now it shows zero. So connect the leads and see what happens. You see, it shows me minus 4.07. Hop, zero. Minus 4. There is also select possibility. So many measurements possible with this excellent device. Temperature getting hot, 26. I like it very much. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos. The battery is working, you see, in this device. Too much carbon dioxide. It's getting down. I was talking close to it, so I throw too much carbon dioxide. It shall go under 1000. Or I need to open the window. Here is this Tronic battery unboxed in another video. Right now it shows minus 1.55. It's good. And when red is on minus, black is on plus, it shows minus voltage. But when I switch the polarity, the voltage is shown in plus 1.5. And here is another measurement from the electricity. This is the frequency range in hertz, 50 hertz as per specs, 220 volts. Here I can switch to different measurements, and this one is 50. Very nice. And now the same test setup for testing voltage. Switch to voltage, the first one, and then select 234 volts, more than the 220 required, which is good, in the middle of 220, 250 volts. And now testing the amperage of this Sony NPFV charger. 7.5 amperes. Nice charger. Strong one. Here is the configuration used. And here is an adapter that I use for this Sega Mega Drive 16-bit gaming console. The voltage is 12. This is very picky console. If you don't provide the right voltage, it doesn't work at all or gives bad video signal. So measuring with this multimeter is vital. As you can see, wide range of appliances of this excellent device. And here is the auto backlight. When in dark, it turns the screen to greenish. I am simulating darkness by placing my hand over this photo detector here.